Prague Stadium Rock fans of the world rejoice. Today, the entire Muse library is being released in the U.S. This UK band has successfully fused prog rock, classical music, electronica, and pop. They've won countless awards, and their shows sell out in minutes. Not bad for three dudes who went to community college. While in Devon, England, the three members of Muse, Christopher, Dominic, and Matthew, who will, fingers crossed, one day be paying me palimony, studied at Teignmouth Community College. There, in addition to honing their musical skills, they also picked up excellent woodworking techniques. Their ashtrays, lamps, and bookends, lovingly crafted from the finest pine and polyurethane, can each be purchased on their tour for just 10 installments of $19.99. With their four studio albums, Showbiz, Origin of Symmetry, Absolution, and Black Holes and Revelations, they have received global acclaim and have had several people try and rip them off. In 2003, Muse successfully sued Nescafé when they used Muse's version of Feeling Good for an ad without the band's permission. Now, I'm no legal eagle, but I've got to know who was the brain trust at Nescafé that said, it's only a $1 million ad campaign on international television. They won't even notice. The crypt keeper of 90s pop, Celine Dion, was also threatened with legal action by the band when the diva planned to name her Vegas show Muse. Understandably, the band didn't want anyone to think that they were playing backup for Celine Dion. Due to the current economic crisis, however, Muse might actually try and make an extra buck by standing in for Dion's current backup band. Although instead of providing frivolous synth harmonies, they plan on screaming, wailing on their axes, and setting the diva's 10-foot weave on fire. Despite their current success, early on, few knew what to make of the group. One record label had reservations about frontman Matthew Bellamy's vocal style, saying it wasn't radio-friendly. In fact, they asked him if he wouldn't mind sounding a little bit more like Celine Dion. No wonder he wanted to sue her. Their 2003 album Absolution went gold in the U.S., featuring the hit singles Time Is Running Out and Hysteria, both of which tracks described the apocalypse as the band became increasingly more fearful of Celine Dion's popularity. Muse has staged some spectacular live shows, including at London's Wembley Stadium and New York's Madison Square Garden. They truly are an incredible live act, and I say this from experience. Seeing them in New York was the first time I ever got my tits out at a concert. It was quite liberating. In fact, I now do it routinely for any number of daily events. For Double Coupon Thursdays,